All right, everybody, welcome to the Hooking the Prophets by the Horn Rhino Suite 2 webinar. We're officially going to get started here in just a minute, so just wanted to do one more audio check to make sure that it was coming through. I checked my little monitor, it shows that it's there, so hopefully that's good. If you guys want to let me know via chat, all right, thank you very much. Got a confirmation that you guys are able to hear me all right out there. So we're going to go ahead and get started here in about 30 seconds. This is going to be a relatively short webinar. We're looking at about 20 minutes. We're going to talk a little bit about Rhino 2. I'm going to show you some of the incredible indicators that are in here. We're going to jump into OmniTrader and look at some real life, real world examples, and then wrap this thing up. So it is officially 4 o'clock here in Austin, Texas, so we're going to go ahead and get started. Again, I want to welcome everybody to the webinar, Hooking Prophets by the Horns. This is Rhino Suite 2. And on top of that, I want to thank you for taking time out of your day to come spend, you know, 20 minutes, 30 minutes with me while we look at this incredible plugin. So if you have any questions throughout the webinar, go ahead and use the questions pane. I'll be happy to answer them as I see them. And let's go ahead and get started. Just going to make sure that my screen actually updates for you guys when it goes through. Looks like it updated. So real quick, before we get into what Rhino Suite is, wanted to get into a little bit of the history of it. I'm particularly fond of this plugin, as it is one that I have created from the ground up with help from various different areas and aspects in the trading world. But the Rhino Suite is basically from the ground up. It was designed to give your average trader, your day trader, your home trader, an advantage that the institutions have. And the history of this is it's been probably 10 years ago when we were in our other building. We had some developers coming in that worked for a rather large financial institution. And I went to lunch with them one day and we were talking just about trading. You know, we were going to be doing a business partnership with Nirvana and them at the time. And the gentleman I was befriending at the time brought up that trading really wasn't nearly as difficult as most people think. He was saying that there's keys that these financial institutions are using to mark their levels way before any trading happens for the day. And, you know, over the time that we sat there and had lunch, we became friends and we talked for the next couple of weeks. And he kind of gave me some insight on what they're doing to really kind of plan out and be able to take some big gains. So that's what was the initial ignition or starting point of the Rhino Suite. And the very first thing that I created was this thing called First Print. And basically, the gentleman who I was talking about said that most of the institutions don't really look at, like, you know, your typical movement throughout the day. They use their popular tools, you know, like VWAP, which is also included in this, which is volume weighted average price. But a lot of their levels that they were setting up their automated trading systems off of came in off of what was called the first print. And basically, every stock or ETF has that very first tick of the day, which is not when the market opens, but typically hours and hours before. And they use that tick to calculate the price range for the remainder of the day. And originally, this is the original first print indicator that I had on here. And the first print or the first tick of the day comes in at 3 a.m. on SPY. That's central time. So you'd have to do the time adjustment for wherever you live. But that's where it came in. And all of the levels were based off of that one tick. So there's a little bit of a math calculation that goes in on top of it. But what this indicator does is it plots for the remainder of the day where these key levels are. And the earlier version of it, you can see that there's a lot of lines. And, you know, the idea was to call out these points. But when you have so many lines in there, you know, if you have enough lines, something's going to hit. But on the initial one, it was kind of to just represent how well these reversal points were based off of that initial value that we got off of the very first tick of the day. So as that was going through, you know, we kind of use the term market structure as these are going to be the levels that the indexes are going to be following. And as the years have continued along and we've been watching, I've been using this since then, but you know, it more often than not is a very good predictor of where the market is going to be heading. And there's a couple of key points like these two points right here where there's market activity that's coming in that also can be identified and help guide your trading throughout the day in a lot of days, not every day, but a lot of days. And we cover that in the actual training with this as well. So based off of that idea, I used the first print for a couple of years, and then I started to add on to this idea. The first print really only at the time only worked on the SPY, the DAI, and the Qs. So it was kind of limited in what it did. You know, most people want to do more than just trade the index ETFs. So what I started to do is I took the idea of the first print and then I kind of made it a larger scale. I did it for end of day. And what I did is I created something called the Rhino Harmonics. So it uses a concept very similar to that first print, but it's actually using a segment of data. Since the first print doesn't actually exist on a daily or weekly or monthly chart, what I'm using is the first month worth of data. So on a daily chart or a monthly chart, it's going to be using this segment of data. In this example, January to February, it's using that data, and then it will calculate the lot or the levels for the remainder of the year. And you can see the results are, you know, pretty spot on as far as where the reversals are in each one of these pullbacks using these harmonic levels. So that's where it kind of transitioned to. I had the first print, which was primarily for the index ETFs, and then started to create things for stocks. In this example, I did use the SPY, but it works for any type of stock. Well, that's really fine and dandy, but I'm a kind of a visual person and levels don't always give me everything that I need. So then what I did is I started doing research on early indications on when the market's going to be moving. It's great to have some key levels along the way, but if you're able to go and see in real time where that market is shifting with a huge sample of consensus among, in this particular case, the Rhino summary, this down here, at the time it used 16 different moving averages, oscillators, and momentum indicators working in conjunction to give you direction or sentiment on what was going to be happening. So I went from the first print into the harmonics, and then I started giving myself some visual representation of what was happening early. And in this example down here at the bottom, you can see we were in this bearish indecision. Over here to the left, it was actually kind of pulling down into this opening range here, and that's why it's all red. The majority of those indicators, those 16 indicators at the time, were showing that it was primarily bearish sentiment. And then you started to see some shift where the consensus really started to overflow back into the bullishness, and you got a fantastic run up off of that 7 o'clock, 7 a.m. Time frame, and for the remainder of the day, it kind of stayed bullish for the most part. You see a couple of areas where it pulled back. So those were kind of the original three indicators that came with the Rhino Suite, the original Rhino Suite that we came out with. That takes us into Rhino Suite 2. And I mean, Rhino Suite 2 was, it's like starting with a tricycle And then moving up to, you know, a Harley Davidson. I mean, it's a huge difference. The concept is still there, but the powerhouse or the power behind it is just incredibly an incredibly noticeable difference. So what we did is we created all new indicators. A lot of these, which I'm going to talk about in a few minutes, came from some suggestions from people who got the original Rhino and were just enthralled with it. I mean, I've been, well, I don't want to toot my own horn, but even up until yesterday or the day before yesterday, actually, I received four emails about Rhino and how much people have enjoyed it and how much it's changed their view of it. But during this segment, after Rhino had been out for a while, I had been communicating with customers, and they started bringing up things like, "Hey, wouldn't it be cool if we could do this with it?" Or, "Hey, you know, the first print, that's really good, but I think I found something that's going to make it a little bit better." So I started to talk with these customers who had been using it and went through and revamped all of the base indicators that came with it, and then did some research into new ways to use the market structure, market timing, and some key elements that are found throughout a trading day, and come up with some really great new indicators. So the first thing that I developed in the new one is the Rhino bands. And basically, the Rhino bands is it identifies key areas where there's huge shifts in market sentiment. Now, on this, we have three different criteria that have been hit. So over here, it's the coloring on this is a little bit odd. Now, blue is actually meaning positive. So as the Rhino bands down here has the blue coloring, it is representing that you're getting a big shift. Now you'll notice that it's actually about three bars before the Rhino summary. The Rhino summary, of course, was this is the Rhino summary too, which I'm going to talk about in a minute. But the Rhino summary was that collection of indicators showing you that early indication, right? So we had the Rhino bands firing, saying, "Hey, it's, you know, we're shifting." Then you got the confirmation, and then you got the signal that's based off of, you know, some of the systems that are in here all firing in the same direction, which really just gave you an awesome entry position to move forward. So the Rhino band can be used in real time or end of day. It's configured right out of the box to work in both capacities, whether you're an intraday trader or end of day trader. It works on non-based time frame or non-time-based time frames, like HIKE and ASHI, things like that. Works on minute, 3 minute, 5 minute, whatever you want to use. This is really a great indicator to give you some really, really quick turnaround. The next thing that we have is the Rhino Synapse. This is going to be a system that was created that uses a predictive formula to give us an indication on potential price movement. And predictive means that it's going through, it's taking the calculations, some of historic values that it knows, plus setups that it has stored, and it's coming up with a probability of what type of move this is going to be. Now, the signals on the chart are all based off of the Rhino Synapse. And we talked about razor sharp reversals because it just has this ability to really find the bottoms and the tops really, really quickly and really, really accurately. And the indicator or the system down here is just, we plotted it there just to kind of give you an idea of where these things are moving. Now, similarly, down here on the Rhino Summary 2, you can see right as that signal is firing, you're starting to see that shift that also is giving us a little bit of additional confirmation, not as strong as we saw in the other example, but you're starting to see where the bullish is starting to peak up above that zero line and giving us some insight that, you know, we're starting to get some bullish sentiment in those. So that's the Rhino Synapse strategy. Now, earlier I had talked about the customer input, and this is probably one of the biggest areas that we found improvement based on users just like you who have emailed in and helped me come up with a new calculation. So this is the difference between the first print and the original one. Basically, the first print and the original one, you had to manually change the price calculation. So you would go in there, and for the SPY, you'd want to use 0.42, and this is all documented in the Rhino. And for the DAI, you would use something else, and for the Qs, you'd use something else. And then if you wanted to use it on stocks, it was really difficult because the calculation would be so far off based on different stocks. So you might be, let's say, on Apple. In this case, it's 150 a share at the time, and you go to Salesforce, which might have been $1,000. So the lines would be all over the place because it's using this calculation that was based for a different price stock, which made it a little bit cumbersome to use. So one of our customers, and I'm eternally grateful for this, but he gave me some information on just taking that calculation and then applying a couple of other techniques to it to give an automated price target, which eliminates some of the additional noise of the lines and gives us really clear levels all the way through, and it works on every stock right out of the box. So there's no configuration on your part needed. You can go to the index ETFs, you can go to a $1,000 stock or a $50 stock or a $10 stock. It always works exactly as it's supposed to based on this calculation. So it was a huge, huge improvement. And you know, if you're looking at these two charts, if you're trying to trade the first print originally, I found it super useful, but two just opened my eyes even further to the power of this particular indicator. So it was really, really mind-blowing. And that was a really great suggestion that came from our customer base. Now, earlier we were looking at the Rhino summary, and then I threw in this Rhino summary too without really explaining it, but here's the explanation. So the original one, it was this little bit of a histogram-y kind of look, and like I said, it was based on 16 different indicators giving you some insight on the overall market sentiment, or the sentiment rather of that stock. It wasn't market sentiment because it's each one of the stocks individually. However, in Rhino 2, we added an additional 10 indicators into this. So it's very, very inclusive, very, very thorough when it's looking for the potential market sentiment. I keep saying market sentiment, but the sentiment of the stock. So as you can see, we also gave it a negative value versus everything just kind of being positive. And that also came from some customer feedback saying that it's hard to kind of tell exactly where things were because everything was on a positive side. But really having this positive and the negative side indicator in the indicator gave them an opportunity to really start to see when things are shifting. Now here on Expedia, we can see that there's a couple of different colors of red. So red in general means negative, but the dark red means that it's overwhelmingly negative or bearish in it. And as you're in that zone, it starts to move to a pink that's starting to show that, you know, you're getting a lot more of that bullish sentiment in there. So it gives you a little bit more information. The same as if you're in a super strong trend, like over here in February and March, it's super, super dark green, but then you have a pretty significant drop off. And that's, you know, one of those points that you need to be looking at, like, hey, something has shifted, something's changed here. The overall sentiment has changed in that stock. And as you can see over the next few months, it ended up moving lower and lower. And that indicator gave you a really, really good early indication. So as it says, this is one of those indicators that was just drastically improved as we moved into the Rhino Suite too. Now, for those of you who like to get into the systems and really play with things and you know, make changes or code your own indicators or add things in. Rhino Suite 2 added something that was requested countless times from Rhino Suite 1, which was the ability to use the indicators inside of your Omni language. So if you have a pro version of OmniTrader, which most of you do, you can go in there and create your own code using any of the indicators, any of the indicators or systems inside of Rhino Suite 2, and use it in your own coding as well. So we added that in there, which again, we had so many people. Normally, we didn't always put those the ability to take everything from indicators, but we have started to do that, and this was one of those turning points for indicators or for our plugin suites to really just start including all kinds of variables and things that you can do on your own. All right, so now, since we kind of have an overview of the Rhino Suite, I'm not going to really jump into the weeds, but I do want to show you just a little bit of what's going on with the Rhino Suite in real trading. You know, here's what's happening recently for us. So this is an end of day chart. I have the Rhino Suite, Rhino Summary 2 indicator here. This is just going to be the base end of day profile. I'm also going to jump over in real time because there's another indicator that also is extremely helpful. But again, I just kind of wanted to give you some insight or some sight, I guess, on how the Rhino summary is working. So you have right here, you start to see a shift. You had the dark red, then you get some pretty strong green sentiment coming in, which is inducive of a really nice move to the upside. We did get a little bit of sideways consolidation in here, which is represented here, but we've never really shifted balance from the bullish to the bearish. We just kind of went neutral if you're looking at it. And then we started to see some really dark green showing some strength coming in VeriSign up to the point where, you know, we had that last bar right here. And, you know, on the very first negative bar, I mean, this was obviously a red bar, but it was still positive from the day prior. But the first negative day, we had an immediate shift down in here, giving us a really clear indication that, you know, whatever has stopped and we need to kind of pay attention. And from there on out, it's been kind of just a bearish run. Excuse me. Again, here you have Xcel Energy. You had the bullish run come to an end. You had some early indecision right here at the end of August into September. A little bit of a bump, excuse me, but almost immediately, again, you started to see overwhelming bearishness come in, and then it just fell off a cliff, and the Rhino basically caught it all the way down. If you're looking at, you know, just the market or the stock sentiment, it didn't trade that one short. I have this set for longs only, but gives you some really good indication. And then almost immediately it catches that razor sharp reversal, like we were saying, for almost 13% on that run there. So really, really good, insightful and useful indicator information. All right. We'll take a look at just a couple of more, and then we'll jump over to our real time real quick. Again, what I'm really just trying to represent here or show here is how well it's showing that almost immediate shift, where you're not really sitting and waiting to see if something is going to happen. It shows you, and then it gives you a lot of additional confirmation quickly. All right, let's jump over here to the real time real quick. This should only take a second. All right. So there's another indicator that wasn't in the slides, which is the Rhino relative volume, which is actually came across. We were doing a live trading show in our Discord room, and I was trying some new techniques, and you know, a lot of the stocks that we were looking at were extremely volatile stocks. And being able to get some short-term relative volume information on the stocks was incredibly powerful information. If you're not familiar with relative volume, it's a great tool to see when there's abnormal volume coming into a stock. So if you're on, you know, if the stock is moving really, really strongly, but there's not a lot of volume before it, and then you get this huge strike of volume, you know that something is about to shift. So here in this case, the volume, you know, just kind of, you can see down here, it's just kind of meh, right? And then right here, you get that spike, and it has different levels. The yellow is two times normal volume, orange is five times, and then 10 times normal volume is the red, which it hit. You can't see it in that form right there, but right there, out of nowhere, 10 times the typical volume over the last 10 bars. And that's a value that you can select. You can change that in here, but by default, it's over the last 10 bars. So it's 10 times the volume on that bar. And although we were already in a bearish kind of move at that point, we started to pick up a lot of steam. There was a lot of additional confirmation with the Rhino summary right here. It turned dark red for all of our bars, and you were able to basically write it all the way down. Now this one, I have the first print, the original first print on here. Let me go ahead and, I was gonna use that as an example because I didn't remember having it in the slide, but here's the price change. So this is what you would have to do if you went to a different stock. You would come into each one of them. None of it was saved per stock or anything like that. So when I said it was cumbersome, it was kind of cumbersome. But if we go in here and go to the Rhino Suite first print two, everything is already plotted out. You don't have to worry about it. And those key levels are there. Now, the SPY has changed quite a bit since that original slide. Price-wise, it still trades pretty much exactly the same as it always has. And the further in the day that you get, it gets a little bit, you'll get a little bit more noise because of the bars. But this is also because on a lot of them, you have the pre-market set on it as well. Here's one for Insight Corporation, INCY. And again, it's just taking, actually, let's add in the all sessions because it's adding, it's using the first print, like I said. So let's get the data for that run real quick. So on this one, this particular one, the actual first print was right here about, let's see if I can get a, there it goes, 750 was the first print of the day for that. So all of the remainder calculations worked off of that level. I probably should have added a 5 minute before this, but the profile comes with a 2 minute, so that's why it has it on there. But let's take a look at a couple of other ones real quick. Take a look at maybe Apple. One, what's a good mover here? So again, you have those levels that are primed and set up already. Let's do the all sessions here. And again, down here, you can see on the relative volume, the indicator that I actually wanted to show you, just where key moments are. Here, we're well above 10 times the volume of the prior bars. Of course, there's not a lot of prior volume before 8:30. So that one, you know, a lot of volume came into it. But if you're trading pre-market, a lot of that information is super, super useful. Being able to see when things are getting ready. And a lot of times when you're using the relative volume inside of the pre-market, you get really early trading indication. Let's see, it picked up the next day there. Don't want that. So let's zoom in here. So again, you have some good volume coming in here right before you start to see a pretty seismic shift in the sideways trading that gave us some great bullish runs to the upside there. Now, these are just a couple of different stocks and uses and for The Rhino Suite. Let's go back here to floor sessions. It's taking the post market over on the side, so it's not a very good visual representation because it uses all of the data that's there. But what you're going to get out of this is some really clear trading information. So like over here on March 7th, you had those first print levels, and as it came down, you kind of have an understanding that this is going to be a key point to be watching. And it kind of hugged that point. I'm also using VWAP on here for every session. So you know that once you're here and you're holding below VWAP, you're looking for kind of a pullback off of that or a significant move to the upside. This particular case, it hit VWAP at that level and it pushed down right to the next zone. And you'll see this time and time again, just where it's, the levels. Here's CentOS. Not a very good chart, but you can see again, it just comes, almost exactly to the levels every single time. And that's the new calculation that's being used with the first print. So inside of that, there's a whole lot to unpack. And nothing that I'm gonna say in this particular webinar is probably gonna translate completely to the usefulness of it. To the usefulness of all of it. So what we've done is, let's see, reading a note over here. So John is saying, I can't see in end of day why the first print or Rhino harmonic is relevant. Seems that the Rhino summary is the most important ingredient. Rhino summary is a huge on end of day. It's extremely important. On real time, or I'm sorry, on end of day, the first print isn't going to be doing anything because the first print is going to be the real time component of it. Now the harmonic, what it does is it's for longer term investments. So if you're getting into something, like I said, and I probably didn't explain it entirely correct, so I'll do this before I move on. But once you're in an end of day, the harmonic can be broken up into various different segments. So then the example that I showed inside of the PowerPoint, it was based off of a year's worth of information. But if you come in here to the actual Rhino harmonic, and we look at the property values in here, we can set it to different types of levels. So we can do a monthly, a quarterly, or a weekly. So if we wanted to get something that was a little bit more relevant to what we're trading, we can go in and get those levels for whatever we're looking. In that other example, we were looking at the one that was quarterly and with the automatic levels here. And automatic just means that it's going to automatically plot out all of the levels for the remainder of the year. So you can see, based on the quarterly, in this particular case, it uses the information in the first quarter and then it projects where those levels are the remainder of the year. That would, however, be more for a longer term trade. If you're looking for the shorter term trades, or maybe you're looking for a 7 to 10 day kind of move, you can come in here and change it to a weekly or into a monthly view, and it will give you different levels to what you to which you can use to help guide your trading. So that's kind of where those come from. But you're right, the Rhino summary is huge, and I've had a ton of compliments based on how it works. So thank you for that. All right, let's I'm gonna move over to real time one more time. Steve is saying that the example from the S&P today is absolutely amazing. So let's take a look at that one, and then I'm gonna take or show you what else comes with this, because it's one thing to, let's say you have an idea. Let's say we're moving averages. This plugin is moving averages. Everybody kind of has an idea or a concept of moving averages, and you can kind of dip your toes in without having to do much thinking. Well, when you come to a something that's different, like the Rhino Suite, something that you've probably never heard of. It's important to have the backing of some good education in there. So we're gonna take a look at that education as well. So again, when you're looking at this in real time, when you're segmenting out, you're getting a much clearer version of what's going on. So as the day is going, each one of these, you have these levels all marked out for you. Now they're not just splattered across your chart. So like when it's happening, you're going to have levels. It's going to show you where your base set of levels are, but everything is static. So there's no dynamic levels. You're not going to have levels that shift or change. But you can see how every level throughout the session is going to one of these key points that's mapped out based off of that first tick of data. And as you're watching it, throughout the session, you're able to actually see in real time where these levels are and be able to make some educated, insightful decisions based off of those levels. So it's really in real time, it's truly amazing. A little bit of a profit there, about a little under 2/10 of a percent, but really a great setup, especially if you're really watching the intraday. Now, not everybody's into intraday, so let's go over to our slide here. So again, not only do you get, actually, let's go back just a little bit. Let me get to the slide. I don't like to jump around too much, but there is a slide in here, right here. Oop, it's not going to let me go that way. Let me go back this way. Here it goes. So the Rhino Suite 2 includes four indicators, four new indicators that we talked about. It has the Rhino Bands, has the Rhino Summary 2, the Rhino First Print 2, and the Rhino Relative Volume. All of them independently are huge, game-changing types of indicators used for different things, obviously. We've built two brand new strategies for it, a real-time and an end-of-day version. The real-time version is based on the 2-minute, but I find that it works just as well in a 5-minute, or you could go higher, but I like to use it in kind of a smaller time frame if I'm using the first print, just because it gives me that relevant information to what I'm expecting or looking to find in the market early on. We've created a couple of color charts that will give you some representation. A color chart is basically just kind of the layout, if you're not familiar with that terminology. So the real time is going to have like the Rhino summary already pre-configured on there. It has the Rhino bands pre-configured on there. So things that you are able to just click on and have it ready, and you don't have to worry about it. On top of that, we have Omni scans. We talked a little bit about the Omni language, but the Omni scans, another huge component to this product is not just being able to look at the stocks, but finding stocks that are being found for you that meet the criteria of the particular plugin that you're using, which is a huge benefit to anybody who's trying to use, be it Rhino or be it, Elliott Fibonacci. The capability of having stocks delivered that meet exactly the criteria that you're looking for are just incredible. And with the Rhino Suite 2, you're getting the Rhino Suite 1 stuff as well. So you'll have a total of four different Omni scans. You're going to have a Rhino Bear, a Rhino Bear 2, a Rhino Bull, and a Rhino Bulls 2. I haven't updated my list, but it has all of the calculations and everything that's being used in each one of those scans. So you'll have fresh lists delivered to you every single day. So that was some really good, addition to this as well. All right. All right, so let's get back over here. And we were just about to talk about the education. Like I was saying, you can't just go into something that you aren't familiar with and just expect to know and be able to interpret everything that you heard in this marketing webinar. So we've provided a complete Rhino Suite 2 Master's Trading course. It's going to be two videos. It's a little over 2 hours worth of education, going through both end of day examples, real-time examples, how you can configure things differently to use them in a way that might fit your trading a little bit better. And on top of that, once you purchase, you have it all on your dashboard. So we have multiple sessions. We have the education session and then a Q&A session. We broke it up because the Q&A sometimes will go for, you know, 30 or 40 minutes on its own. So you're able to go and see either one of those. And then during the education seminars, I showed you how to create some new strategies based on these different indicators and some of the different values and some of the different parameters. And so you don't have to do it. We've included those in here. So you're actually getting a new scalping strategy as well for those who might want to be doing, you know, 1 minute or maybe lower time frames. You can have that additional strategy in there as well. So a little bit of a bonus for those of you who picked this up. So a really, really great deal. Now, this is, you know, a marketing type of webinar. I'm hoping that you see the value inside of Rhino Suite. It's literally the brainchild and, you know, my pet project for the last couple of years. And it's just, I enjoy it. I use it every single day. I talk about it quite frequently. It's named after me. My name is Ryan O, so I called it Rhino. So, you know, it's pretty much me to the core. But inside of this package, again, you get two powerful end-of-day strategies because you're getting the end-of-day Rhino Suite 1 and Rhino Suite 2. And you're also getting the real-time strategies versus, you know, for the original and the second as well. You're getting the new indicators, the Rhino bands and the Rhino synapse, which are brand new to this. Then you're also getting the improved versions. You'll get both versions, but you're getting the Rhino print and the Rhino print 2, first print and first print 2, the Rhino summary and the Rhino summary 2. And then you're getting the Omni scans, the chart templates, and then 2 hours of training along with that extra strategy, all for a pretty reasonable price. Normally it sells for $5.95. It's been that way since 2001. This is the first time that we've brought the price down on this one, and I think it's a great introductory price. There's a lot of value in it. Of course, it comes with Nirvana Systems 30-day money back guarantee. So if you get into it and find that the education or whatever didn't help you, or our support wasn't able to help you, you know, it's no harm, no foul. We value you and your willingness to give our products an opportunity. So that's a pretty great deal. $3.95. It says pre-order special, but it's just special pricing. It's not pre-order. That was a mistype on my part, so I apologize for that. But also, let me get over here real quick. If you go to nirvanasystems.com/Rhino Suite 2, you'll get over here to the website that has some additional information, some additional examples, some additional changes from the original over. But a lot of it is covered in what we spoke about today. Yeah, so that's kind of where we're going to end this at. I don't want to go too long. If you guys have any additional questions, I'd be happy to answer those now. Other than that, that will be the end of our webinar. So I'll give it just a moment to see if anybody has questions. If not, you will also receive a recording of this in your email tonight. and the special pricing ends tomorrow on that. So there is a little bit of a deadline on it, but a lot of value. And I think the thing that I enjoy the most about it is just the how, first of all, visually pleasing it is. I mean, there's, you know, I think that the Synapse is just hugely valuable for looking at charts just really, really quickly, getting a good idea of where they are and what their potential is. All right, doesn't look like there's any questions coming in, so we're going to go ahead and wrap this up. It's been exactly 45 minutes, so I want to thank each and every one of you for coming out here this afternoon and spending some time with me. And it's good to see a lot of you out there. I see you, Dawn. Been a long time since I've seen you, so it's good to see you back out there. And I hope you guys have a fantastic Friday, and look forward to spending some time with you guys in Rhino too. So from all of us here at Nirvana Systems, we wish you guys the best in all of your trading endeavors, and have a nice Friday and safe weekend.